How y'all doing today? It's your boy Eat Right Guy, and for this video I want to discuss the four things you need to do in every workout. Pretty much the four components. I'm not really going to go into different type of workout plans, such as aerobic versus resistance versus sports specific power and agility training. I'm just going to discuss the four components that should be done every time you hit the gym. And so the four components are the warm-up phase, the conditioning phase, the cool down phase, and the stretching. So first we're gonna cover the warm-up. The warm-up, it should happen at the beginning of your workout. It usually consists of 5 to 10 minutes of low to moderate aerobic or strength training. And the purpose of a warm-up is to get your muscles ready, to get the blood flowing before your conditioning phase. And you don't really wanna go straight in conditioning with cold muscles, because that can cause a lot of health problems, such as muscle tears, muscle aches, hypertension. So you want to stay away from just jumping into conditioning phase. So you always want to start with a warm up, and it can be as anything like a 5 minute walk, 5 to 10 minute jog, dynamic stretching, or doing like push-ups, doing some type of movements that's gonna simulate your conditioning phase, but just to get your muscles warmed up. All right, and so the second phase, conditioning. This is the main, pretty much the bread and butter of your workout. It can last anywhere from 20 minutes to 2 hours. Just depends on you. And this is the aerobics, resistance training, powerlifting, pretty much the main component of your workout. That's the conditioning phase. And so once you're done with the conditioning phase, like the same way you warmed up, you want to cool down. And the cool down, very similar to the warm-up phase. 5 to 10 minutes of low to moderate intensity aerobic or resistance training, just to kind of bring your body back down to normal. You want to do this to help lower your heart rate, help gradually lower your blood pressure, and also it helps your body, it reoxygenizes your body. So you can get rid of some of those waste products in your body that build up, such as lactic acid. And so you always want to have a cool down phase. You don't want to jump straight from a conditioning phase to going home, because it can actually cause hypotension, where your blood pressure drops too low, too fast. And so after that, after your cool down phase, now you want to do stretching. And I pretty much recommend static stretching. And the thing about static stretching, you never want to do this before your conditioning phase. Especially if you're a strength athlete, a power athlete, it's always better to do your stretching after your cool down, because it can actually hinder your performance. So I see a lot of people in the gym, before they do their workouts, they don't do a warm up. They don't do any warm-up cardio. They just go straight into static stretching and then straight into their conditioning phase. And this actually can hinder your performance. So if you want to do static stretching, do it at the end of your cool down. And this can consist of 10 minutes. You want to really stretch the muscles that you worked out. All right? And so that's pretty much broke down the four phases. Remember, warm-up phase, conditioning, cool down, and stretching. If you have any questions, comment at the bottom, or you can send me a direct message. Subscribe, share my videos if you like them, and also I'm on Instagram at Eat Right Guy. Peace out.